This short video will show you how to complete your SBCC application. This video will go over the application process for credit classes only. If your goal is to take classes through our School of Extended Learning, please go to sbcc.edu/extended-learning/. For more information on how to apply to the SBCC School of Extended Learning. If at some point during this video you run into any problems with the application process, you can pause the video and contact the Enrollment Services team by visiting www.sbcc.edu/enrollment-services/. The first thing we are going to do is go to the SBCC homepage at sbcc.edu. Once at the SBCC homepage, we are going to scroll down and click on Apply and Enroll. Once on the Apply and Enroll screen, we are going to scroll down and click on the application link that best fits your current educational status. In this video, we will apply as a first-time to college student. Please note that no matter what your status, you will be able to use this video as a guide. Once you identify what type of student you are, you will click on the appropriate tab. Once you do this, you will then click on Apply to SBCC. We will now be taken to the OpenCCC website. The OpenCCC is managed by the California Community College Chancellor's Office and is a system-wide community college application portal. OpenCCC is not an SBCC portal and will have a separate login. Your SBCC pipeline username and password will not work. Now that we are on the OpenCCC site, you will either click on Create an Account or Sign In. If you have not applied to SBCC before, you will click on Create an Account. If you do not have a Social Security number or tax identification number, check the appropriate boxes. Some international students, non-residents, or others may not have a Social Security number. If you do not have a Social Security number or taxpayer ID, then check the appropriate boxes and also complete an AB 540 form and turn it into our Admissions and Records Department. You can find the form and instructions on the Admissions and Records page on sbcc.edu. If you have applied to SBCC before, you will click on Sign In. If you have any issues logging in, contact CCC Apply directly at 1-877-247-4836. We will now select Sign In. You will now select the term you are applying for from the drop-down menu. Next, you will choose your educational goal. Each person will pick what's most applicable to their educational goal. However, we do not recommend choosing undecided. Students with a goal of undecided are not eligible for financial aid. If you are unsure of your goal or goals, pick the one that best fits your goal today. Next, you will select your intent to major or program of study from the drop-down list. You will see the name of the major followed by letters. AA and AS means associate's degree. AST means associate's degree for transfer, and C means certificate. However, we do not recommend choosing undeclared. Undeclared majors are not eligible for financial aid. Once you have chosen the major, you will click on Continue. On the next screen, you will review your OpenCCC account information. Review it and click Continue. You will now click on the College Enrollment Status drop-down box and choose your enrollment status. In this example, we will be selecting Received High School Diploma from US School. Next, you will answer Last School Attended. Choose what best fits you. In this example, we will be selecting I Attended High School. Depending on your answers, you may be asked to provide the name and location of your school. Please make sure that the name of your school is correct. Depending on your answers to the education questions, you may be asked to answer high school transcript information. This information is required to place you into English and math levels. It is important to take a moment and make sure that the information is listed correctly. You can find this information on your high school transcripts or make your best estimate. If you have any questions, pause this video and reach out to our assessment staff by sending an email to assessment@pipeline.sbcc.edu. Once you complete this information, we will click on Continue. You will now move on to the Citizenship Military section. You will choose what best fits your personal situation from the drop-down list when answering citizenship and immigration status. Depending on your answers, you may be prompted to provide additional information based on your specific situation. For example, a visa type or alien registration number. If you choose other and do not have a visa, you will click on the Note Documents box. If other is your answer to this section, you will also need to complete an AB 540 form and submit it to our Admissions and Records Department. You can find the AB 540 form and instructions on the Admissions and Records page of the SBCC website. In this example, we are going to choose U.S. citizen. Next, you will answer the U.S. military dependent of military questions. Choose the answer that fits your situation. In this example, we are going to choose none applied to me. Then click continue. Next, you will answer the residency section of the application. Choose the answer that best fits your situation. It is important to answer these questions accurately. Depending on your answers, you may be prompted to provide additional information. Once you complete this section, you will click Continue. In this example, we will be selecting California residency. With no boxes checked for out-of-state activities and no to special residency categories. Then click Continue. Next, answer the needs and interests section. This information will not be used to make admissions decisions or decisions about financial aid eligibility. Choose what best fits your personal needs and interest. Once you complete this section, click on Continue. Next, answer the demographic information section. Gender and transgender or sexual orientation information is optional and voluntary and is only used for statistical purposes. You can choose to decline to state for these questions. This information will not be used to make admissions decisions or decisions about financial aid eligibility. Once you complete this section, you will move on to parent or guardian and then to the race ethnicity questions. The U.S. Department of Education requires colleges to collect racial and ethnic data. This information will not be used to make admissions decisions or decisions about financial aid eligibility. When completed, click on Continue. Next, answer the supplemental questions section. You are now nearing completion of the application. The list of four-year colleges and universities under future transfer plans does not list all four-year schools, so you may not find your school listed. If your transfer school is not listed, pick one that best fits your educational goals. If you do not plan to transfer, then choose no transfer plans. Next, answer the primary language and employment expectations question. Choose what best fits your personal situation. This information will not be used to make admissions decisions or decisions about financial aid eligibility. Next, answer the SBCC Promise question. The SBCC Promise is a program through the Foundation for SBCC and should not be confused with the California Community College Promise Grant, formerly known as the BOG, the Board of Governors Fee Waiver. If you are unsure about your eligibility, you can find more information about the SBCC Promise on their website at sbccpromise.org. Next, answer the Support SBCC question, then click Continue. Next, you will have a chance to review your responses. After reviewing, you will scroll down and click on I Consent. Clicking on I Consent allows the Chancellor's Office, which manages the OpenCCC site, to forward your application to SBCC's Admissions and Records Department. After clicking on I Consent, you will scroll down to the final section, submitting your application. Once you submit your application, changes cannot be made. Next, click and check the two boxes declaring the information you have provided is correct and that you understand that financial aid programs are available. Next, click on I Submit My Application. Next, you will see your application has been submitted. We recommend taking a screenshot, a picture with your phone, or saving a copy of your CCC ID and the confirmation for your records. Having this information can be very helpful if there are any issues that come up in the future. Congratulations, your application has been submitted. It can take up to 24 hours for your application to be uploaded into the SBCC system. If after 24 hours you are unable to create or log into your pipeline account, contact the Enrollment Services team by visiting www.sbcc.edu/enrollmentservices/. If you found this video helpful, we have a similar video to help you with registering for classes. When it is time for you to register for your classes, you can find this video by visiting www.sbcc.edu/enrollmentservices/. Finally, we are here to help you if you have any questions about the application process that weren't covered in this video. You can contact the Enrollment Services team by visiting www.sbcc.edu/enrollmentservices. Thank you for your attention to this presentation, and good luck with all of your academic pursuits.